Hey everybody, Yuri here, and today we're going to take a look at the inputs and outputs of MOTIV Mix. Over here on the left are all of my possible sources. These are all the potential inputs that I can put into my mixer. This includes both things that are connected physically to my computer via USB and also some virtual options like MOTIV Mix Virtual, which we will take a look at in a little bit. The first one is going to be my single channel tabletop interface that is permanently connected to my computer. This has a Shure KSM32 going into it right now, and it is live. You can see the input meter going as I speak. I'm also going to add a second interface that's connected to my computer. This is my mobile recording interface that I normally take out to do all sorts of recording sessions. But when I'm at home, I also keep it connected to my computer. And that one has this SM58 plugged into it, and I'm talking into it as we speak. Here we go. Hey, hey, check, check. I also have connected my Shure MV7 Plus, which is the microphone that I'm speaking into right now. So here I am talking into the Shure MV7 Plus. And I also have the Shure MV6, which is right here on my table, connected to the computer as well. And here I am speaking into that as well. The cool thing about having MOTIV microphones connected as inputs to your mixer is that I can go into the settings and I can control all of my settings from within the MOTIV Mix app. So right now, you can see I have one physical interface over here. I have a second physical interface over here connected via USB. I also have the Shure MV7 Plus microphone, which I'm speaking into right now in front of my face. And then I also have the Shure MV6 microphone all together, all going in as inputs to MOTIV Mix. Okay, so what is this mystery MOTIV Mix Virtual over here? So this is what we call a virtual audio path. I can select it as my fifth input over here in MOTIV Mix. So why would I want that? Well, I do a lot of training, like mixing training and recording training videos. So I can actually take the output of my digital audio workstation software and set it to go to MOTIV Mix Virtual. So the moment I hit play here, the string quartet that I'm working on is going to go directly into MOTIV Mix. That's pretty cool. So this MOTIV Mix Virtual path allows you to route stuff from software that's running on your computer directly into MOTIV Mix. Now, if your software doesn't have selectable audio outputs, like my digital audio workstation did, you can still send sound from your computer to MOTIV Mix. You just have to go into your global computer sound settings and just set your computer output to MOTIV Mix Virtual, and you'll be ready to go. Now that I've set up my inputs and I've mixed them accordingly, all I have to do is choose where it goes, and that's where my main output is for. So in this case, I can choose any of my devices that are connected. So maybe this Shure MV7 Plus will also be my main output. And now if I'm using a broadcasting software or some kind of live streaming, whatever, all I have to do is make sure that my output of MOTIV Mix is going to be my input into that software, and they will get everything. And last but not least, the last item in my mixer section is the monitor path, which is set up for you to listen to any of your input sources. You can choose any device that you have to be your monitor path. It just cannot be the same as your main output. So for example, the Shure MV7 Plus is currently my main output, so it is grayed out in my monitor path. Also, keep in mind that if my monitor path is one of my inputs, I am not able to listen to that input through that path. But any of my other inputs, here we go. I can monitor one of them, or I can monitor both of them and listen to them in real time. And that is all. And there you have it. That's how to navigate the inputs and outputs of the MOTIV Mix app. If you have any other questions, please leave them in the comments, and we'll see you next time.